acid and new. And we can already see them starting here. Basha is already pushing up a bit with the shaft and... What's the name of that hull? I completely forgot. Anyways, they're already pushing up. Nicely done there. Nopmet has a real chance of pulling the flag here. Taking off with it really quickly. Easy is there right behind him to back him up. Good thing Sneaky spawns there as well, and that's going to be a capture for sure. Sneaky is not letting up though, he's still hiding there, doing damage to Knockout. LeBron moving in, Easy is trying to support him a bit. It's a good thing team damage is off right now. Allows them to use Striker very efficiently. The only thing standing between Shulia and this Easy and this capture is Shulia, but he was too far away there, unfortunately. Seemed like a great opportunity for Knockout to make a push there, but two of their members were already taken out way before they even got to Red Notice's flag. Reklo doing 360s on Sneaky, just trying to show off a bit. This is looking promising for Red Notice once again. Although Shulia does put an end to that, in all honesty, but Osid there. And that overdrive by Basha, that's crucial. I believe he took out two players with his overdrive, that's great. LeBron pulling the flag. It's not a sure capture yet. New is still there, but he's being detained there by Basha. He can't get too far there. And Sneaky gets his hands on yet another flag. It's not looking that great for Knockout currently. The momentum is all for Red Notice. Sneaky attempting to pull there, but luckily Reklo was paying attention there. Even if they don't pull, as long as Easy there stays alive, it's going to be a huge nuisance to Knockout there, since he can always do damage with a Striker Dictator there. And that's going to be the fifth capture already. This is going incredibly well for Red Notice. New and Heaven pushing in together with Shulia. Heaven has a chance of pulling the flag here, but LeBron and Nodmurt are in his way and they manage to take him out before he even touches the flag. Great job by them. Although it's not looking that great for Knockout currently. Sneaky pulling another flag when no one's paying attention. Very ironic. Heaven is still there, but he's unable to do much, but new with his overdrive. And that's going to be the first capture for Knockout. It's not much when you compare it to 5 flags, but it's a start. And that overdrive, once again, it's so efficient when used well. Basha is doing an amazing job there. LeBron attempting yet another flag, but Reklo was right behind him there, unable to do much. Reklo gets his hands on the overdrive box as well. This is going to be the second capture for Knockout already. It is looking pretty good for Red Notice still. 3 flag lead is not nothing, but in a map like Sandbox, like things can change very, very quickly, so. Easy and sneaky, both with the overdrives, trying to take some control. Yeah, this is going to be a capture almost for sure. LeBron and Notmert pushed up from the other side, they got complete map control. Iki coming back there a bit, just to make sure Heaven doesn't get too far. Someone asking if tanks float now, yeah. These are the new hulls. The hull that Shulya is using is Ares, and the hull that Sneaky is using is Paladin. New here with the flak, he might have a chance here. Osit is dead to help him out. Notmert with the block, it's going to be annoying for them, and LeBron gets a return. Trying to fight for the overdrive box as well, but he's outnumbered and doesn't have much of a chance there. LeBron and Sneaky attempting to pull another flag, on the other hand, Reklo as well. This might be a standoff if both teams succeed in pulling the flag here. Which it looks like they will. A little bit of server lag there. And that's going to be yet another capture for Knockout. Gap slowly tightening. Osit pulling the flak with his overdrive. Paladin overdrive is really great when pushing with their teammates, since it heals both you and a teammate when you're near them. New, he didn't use his overdrive, but LeBron certainly did, and that's going to be the return for Red Notice. As well as the capture, making the score 7-3. I don't know what you guys were expecting, but honestly, I wasn't expecting this result. I thought it would be a bit more balanced. Although this is only the first round, it does look very good for Red Notice right now. LeBron managing to circumvent Shulya here. Runs into Heaven, who is blocking his path, and eventually manages to take him out as well. Easy with his overdrive. He's going to attempt to pull the flak while he still has his critical damage there. And this is why Paladin is so overpowered. Sneaky is just sticking close to him, and pretty much no opponents can come nearby unless they use their overdrive themselves. Since both Paladin will heal you and your allies, plus it will deal AP on your opponents whenever they get nearby, so that's really, really important if you want to win in, I'd say, pretty much any CTF side of map. And that will be the 10th capture already for Red Notice. Teams are currently not very balanced, but who knows what we'll see in the future. Osit pulling the flag though. Might make it up a little bit by capturing the 4th flag for his team. Which he does, right before time runs out even. Heaven is attempting to capture yet another flag, but unfortunately there's simply not enough time. It was a nice attempt though. Alright, by the way, for the people wondering, after this map, we'll be watching SandalMM, which will definitely be interesting since the map is somewhat like Sandbox, but at the same time completely different. Like, the area is somewhat similar, but the layout of the map is different. I mean, it's symmetrical, or somewhat symmetrical as well. But there are many pathways you can use where your opponents cannot shoot you. Teams are trying to fight for the overdrive box right now. It's a very important part of the round because whoever gets it will have it before any of their opponents do. The great thing is if it falls early, then it will fall twice before the map even starts, which will give a huge advantage to whoever will get it. As of right now, no overdrive box yet. It will probably fall before the start of the round though. As of right now, nothing yet, surprisingly. And there the overdrive box does come. And Sneaky will be the one to get it, which is going to be very important since Aladdin is really an overpowered hull. If he uses this correctly, then it can result in them capturing the first flag for sure. Also, a question about will we be adding the overlay the Russian stream has in the near future? If at all possible, definitely yes. Which basically means I don't know, but we'll try to. Easy, Notmert and Pasha pushing for some map control. Pasha being alive in this corner right here is very important for Red Notice, since he can simply distract his opponent, one-shot them, or pretty much just cut off rotations altogether. Easy unleashes his entire folly of rockets, but still manages to shoot half of them on the slope, which I guess is just simply a good move from heaven by hiding there. Pasha still saving his overdrive for when his opponents pull the flag or whenever he has to use it in self-defense. Seems to be a good choice. Reklo though, he did have a chance there, but Northmurt was simply out of his range, so even if he did use his overdrive, he wouldn't have accomplished much there. Sneaky trying something. If he takes out Reklo, he has a chance here, but they take out each other. And Northmurt gets a chance, but he gets taken out as well by Heaven. Pasha does exactly what he's meant to by cutting off rotations here, but still, they are unable to pull the flag here because Shulya does his job very well. Just making sure they can't pull the flag, but he has to move eventually, and that's when Easy comes in and takes the flag. LeBron's still there, Sneaky, Sneaky. Does he have enough time? And he does, just barely get the capture there. before OZ manages to take Red Notice's flag and is running away. His overdrive quickly healing him, Heaven using his overdrive as well for insurance. LeBron didn't manage to take out Heaven there. I'm pretty sure he knew the overdrive box was going to fall, so he wanted to fight for control in middle. Osit is the one who managed to get it, and he will try to use it, but if you're not even close to the flag, then it's simply a waste to use it. So he decided to first see how far he can come. And not Mud actually drops the flag for Pasha. I think it has something to do with getting his overdraft to recharge quicker. Although I do have to say that the shaft Pasha is using does look very, very nice. Reminds me of the old times. And that's going to be yet another capture for Red Notice. I really do hope it is looking better for Knockout in the next map. Although they still have a chance to come back here. Easy, just doing his best to defend here, even with his low HP, still managing to deal damage to Rackler, who manages to outlive all of his enemies there. He's trying to go for the pull, but Pasha is there to take him out to stop him, and Sneaky has the correct spawn to return just on time. Otherwise, that could have been real dangerous for Red Notice there. Osit gets a flag after capturing one. It's not enough yet, and actually the Hunter overdrive doesn't affect him because he had his own overdrive there, I believe. And new with the equalizer. This is already really good for Knockout here. They simply managed to tie this round, and it's already way better than losing, considering that if they lose this round, then Red Notice simply have to tie the following round to win this match. Easy with the attempt, but the pull wasn't that easy though. His opponents were definitely paying attention there. Pasha doing his job as always, just making sure his opponent, being a Knockout, can't pass him that easily. Or at least he'll be able to warn his teammates way beforehand. Heaven's still attempting the pull here since he can't simply stop once he has taken action, but it's pretty futile considering he doesn't have any teammates with him there. Little bit of server lag doesn't benefit either team. This is looking pretty good for Knockout actually. They've got control over both sides of the map, so as long as they have supplies, or maybe an overdrive, they might be able to pull the flag, but unluckily for them, they have neither. And their opponents are just spawning in, they have full supplies, some of them even have overdrives, so there's not much chance of succeeding for them there, unfortunately. LeBron here with the bull. This is going to be the fourth capture already. There's been a while when nothing really happened, but currently it's favored to a red notice once again. And not Mert. If he does manage to capture this flag, then it will be very difficult for Knockout to catch up, especially considering how well red notice have been playing here. Shuya flipped on his side, still tries to the scope and just waiting. Just as long as he doesn't shoot, he's still stalling for time. Which unfortunately proves to be futile here. Heaven trying to go for the push there, but he's all by himself. Or perhaps it was just a distraction. Seeing Osid and New come from the other side, but LeBron has a decent spawn there, which causes them to have to turn around. Otherwise their base would be in jeopardy, so. Osid and New have a chance here, but New already gets taken out, and Osid, he barely gets to touch the flag before being taken out. Niki managing to take out New there. Just making sure nothing can happen within the last 20 seconds. Even if Oze does manage to capture this flag, I'm afraid there's not enough time for them to come back during this round. Which he will manage to capture the fourth flag here, but yeah, pretty much every player from Red Notice is spawning in their base currently. And that's going to be the end of the round with a scoreline of 5-4 for Red Notice. Alright, so we're going to be waiting for the next map, which will be Sandal. I'm looking forward to seeing a different map, so hopefully Knockout are able to put up more of a fight in that map. And also, while we wait for the next map, I'd like to introduce my fellow commentator and team leader of the livestream team, The Legend. Welcome.
Hello, and thanks for the lovely introduction. I'm sorry for letting you stay alone, man, but it's really out of my hand. So yeah, how are you?
I'm doing alright, thank you. What about you?
I'm great, thanks. Let me take a look at the match. So I'm not going to ask you what is happening exactly. You know, because I know that you probably need to take some rest. But yeah, while we are waiting for the next map, maybe you can just tell me, like, who's doing better than the other one? Because this one I will have to see it right now. So yeah, you can tell me about this one.
I mean, that's going to be pretty simple. So basically, Red Notice has won both rounds. In the first round, they dominated pretty much. They were always leading. But in the second round, it was a bit more of a back and forth. They were tied at a certain point, and Red Notice simply managed to capture two flags towards the end of the map, and they just defended it out, let's say.
Interesting.
Also, for people in the chat, I'd like to clarify that Arcade and Happy are not commentators, so they're simply here, just to listen in. Also, yes, we do read the chat.
Yeah, guys, we do read the chat. We'll be answering questions. In case if you have anything to ask us, we will answer it. I mean, only for the time being, while we are waiting for the second map to be created. So, yeah. Second map, as we said, is going to be Sandal matchmaking. So yeah, at least it's not the same map for today. Let's see if we do have received the link yet. Okay, I believe we have got the second link for the Sandal map. Let's go there.
Right, Sandal's ready.
Okay, let's go. As you guys already know, this is the first match of the new Legend stage.
Also, someone was asking, can we open bets on who's winning next round? We can see if we will do that for next stream, but I think it's a bit biased towards Red Notice currently, since they're already leading 2-2-0. They simply need to tie just one more round, and that's going to be the end for knockout.
Yes, exactly.
They'll get knocked out, quite literally.
But you know, like, usually we see some competition happening in Sandal. I know that Sandbox is a totally different map. Like, it's a very fast-paced map. And usually, when a team starts capturing flags, they don't stop. And we see, like, we see the scores going very high easily there. Like, it can go up to 10 flags with no issues. Yeah, even 5 versus 5. I'm not saying, like, 5 versus 2 or something like that. But yeah, Sandal, I prefer Sandal, to be honest. It's a little bit smaller than Sandbox matchmaking. I mean, if it was a regular Sandbox, then it was going to be another story. But Sandbox MM is actually bigger than Sandal. And as you know, Sandal is a symmetrical map. Red side is the same as the blue side, with only one difference in the center. Is that tower thingy which you go to the repair kit, but other than that, it's totally the same. So yeah, the players have rejoined and we are waiting these 2 minutes before the start of round number 3. Are Red Notice going to win the third round and end this battle, or there is going to be a chance from the other team, which is knockout? We will have to wait and see. Maybe knockout will actually do something. I mean, these players, most of them are actually known, they are famous, they are good, so we should see some nice gameplay.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that's what I said before. I was quite surprised that Red Notice managed to take such a huge lead, especially in the first round. Considering that knockout, they really do have good players.
Mm-hmm. Yes, indeed. Did Nuclear Box fall yet? Because I didn't actually see.
Yeah, not Mert got it.
Okay. Oh, yeah. He's the one who have the overdrive on him.
Yes, exactly. I mean, he's the only one, so it's it's yeah, pretty obvious.
Yeah, makes sense. Okay. Yeah, let me see. I'm reading if there are actually questions for people who are asking us. We are doing great. Thank you, guys. I hope that you are having fun. And as you know, a promo code will be appearing on the screen after each round. It can be used by everyone who is watching the live stream. So everyone is considered as a winner. Like, you don't have to be fast enough to claim the promo code or anything like that. Anyone who puts it will get a reward. So yeah, round number 3 has just started, and another OD box is dropping into the center. Who is going to take it? Is it LeBron? LeBron is going for it, and oh,
he does not get it.
He dies under it, and not Mert uses his OD and takes the other one once again. Wow, man, the round has just started and it's already getting very intense. This is so interesting. Sneaky has returned the flag. So far, it's still 0-0. Yes, the round has just started. But man, I can feel that we are going to see some nice and good gameplay here happening in this round.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, what Notmert just did, I mean, it's a very typical play in esports. People simply use their overdrives right before taking an overdrive box just to make sure the opponents don't get it. I mean, that's worth more for them.
Yeah, it's a technique which we all use, but look at Pasha. Oh, nice overdrive, but the flag was returned already. So, probably not the best use for it. I mean, Ares OD will never use it anyway. You will kill some players with you, but it depends on when do you actually use it. But LeBron, once again, is taking the flag. He doesn't have too much HP, but Oskate is behind him. Sneaky takes it once again. There is no one near him to return. That can actually be a secure capture for the red team. Red Notice. I suppose our red team and Red Notice.
I mean, it is very similar. Like, Red Notice is playing for the red team, so...
Yeah.
I mean, you could play both, to be honest. Like, it doesn't even matter.
It actually makes sense, you know, like came in the right time. But yeah, we have almost 8 minutes remaining, and it's 1-0 for Red Notice. But actually, I see that Knockout are playing good. Maybe because they didn't use their overdrives yet. When they will start to use them, maybe we'll see some difference. But so far, they are playing fine. What was the score of the previous rounds? Red Notice won, but what was the score?
In the first round?
First and second, yeah, if you remember.
In the first round, I don't recall correctly. I mean, I don't remember it entirely, but I'm pretty sure it was something like 8-5 or something like that.
Oh, so it was pretty close. Okay.
Yeah, considering. I mean, that could be a way bigger lead, but... they were leading pretty much the entire round, so it didn't come as a surprise.
Oh, okay. Wow, man. While we were talking, actually, I saw a very nice push from Knockout from the left side. The OD of Dictator gave the supplies to everyone, but looks like they still didn't touch the flag. But yeah. It's only one flag, 1-0. Anything can happen. Maybe we can see a tie or a win. But I have to mention that Knockout have to win in order to play a fourth round, because getting a tie will not help them do so. But look at Easy using his overdrive and the repair kit on center. Is it okay? LeBron and Sneaky. This is going to be a capture whenever they use it, because Notmert. Sneaky,
he
LeBron,
does get taken
out.
Oh, wow. I think you jinxed it. I'm pretty sure you jinxed it. Just as you were talking about it, all of them got taken out.
Okay. What do you mean by that? What do you mean?
I mean, you jinxed it. That's it.
No. I'm saying like, what? Why are you saying this? Okay, man. It's okay. They still have their overdrives. They will just use them, you know, right now. And anyway... they have to capture more because, you know, they can't really rely on one flag. But still, any flag they capture, it will make it harder for Knockout, because they have to win instead of getting a tie. They can't get a tie.
Exactly. And right now, Red Notice is still winning, so it doesn't look great for Knockout here. They definitely have to do something, and they have to do it as soon as possible. They still have a bit over 5 minutes left, but I haven't seen much, aggression from them. They definitely have to take more map control if they want to capture a flag here.
Mm-hmm, indeed. I was reading the chat and someone is saying fake. What is fake? If you mean about the promo code appears after each round. And wow, what a nice flip there by LeBron. I will have to take a screenshot of that later and post it to him. Because as you guys know, LeBron is one of the commentators in our team, so yeah, we do these funny jokes between each other. And look at that OD killing everyone in its way. Oh my god, man, that was so close, the Hunter OD. But LeBron comes with OD as well and not allowing the flag to escape from his own base.
Yeah, I'm sure Racklow definitely didn't see that one coming. Sneaky still with his overdrive. If he does use it here, this is going to be very dangerous for Knockout.
They have to stop him. At least he didn't use his OD, but yeah. Look, man, it's still close for knockout. Till Red Notice captures the second flag, then pretty much it will be over. Because they will have to capture three. And we only have 4 minutes remaining, so yeah.
Yeah, that's going to be incredibly difficult. And I do think it's possible in theory, but... like, to actually do it, it's way more difficult. Sneaky, with the overdrive, an easy ride behind him. This is going to be a capture almost for sure. Unless New can get there with his overdrive, but he's too far away. Or not. Oh, Pasha once again with his overdrive. He's using it so efficiently.
Yeah, of course. Of course. Like,
and
that's
Sneaky managed to capture the second flag there.
He's already like... he was using Ares for a long time, and pretty much every one of these players knows when and how to use Ares OD. I mean, it's because the overdrive was buffed anyway, but still, it needs some sort of skill. It's not just like, use it and let it go.
Exactly. Also, there's another overdrive box falling here. I don't think Osid noticed yet, or he does,
he's simply pretending not to. Yeah.
He didn't want to be out in the open for too long, which makes sense.
Yeah, because, you know, normal tanks sometimes go under hovering hull. So, yeah, maybe he was giving space to himself. But, yeah, 2-0. And in order to go for a fourth round, they will have to capture three flags right now. But I have to say that they have played well. It's not like they lost badly or anything, but yeah, Red Knots are playing better, and it is what it is. As Jack, our commentator, always say, it is what it is.
I mean, he does say that a lot, to be honest.
I know.
Osid actually with the overdrive, but he half flips there, and Racklow doesn't manage to get the flag there, and LeBron returns it. And this, it doesn't spell well for knockout here. They still have a slim chance of dying the round at least, but... winning is very unlikely at this point.
Yeah, it's pretty much over right now, but they are still trying. Maybe they can capture a flag at least, you know, like ended up with a 2-1 instead of 2-0. Wouldn't make any difference, but yeah, just for a better score anyway. And oh, the hunter uses his OD, but it doesn't touch anyone at all. But yeah, it was a nice attempt to get with the flag. Who have overdrive right now? Okay, only
Easy as far as I can see.
Easy, and he uses it right now. And another one is falling. Who is going to take it? Is it Heaven? Oh, he gets killed, and oh wow, man, what a nice fight under that OD box over there.
Not mad managing to snatch it from everyone and everyone's noses.
He took it like two or three times so far.
I mean, I do have to say he's pretty good at controlling it.
Well,
I mean, either he has a great sense of timing, or he has a timer running.
Or maybe luck.
It could be as well.
There is luck factor as well.
LeBron doesn't want to leave it up to luck, and he's trying to pull the flag by himself there. Sneaky.
Okay, a little bit of turbo lag
all by himself
over there.
That overdrive by Notmert is crucial.
He's going around just to go, and he self-destructs. Leaving it to Pasha, and it's a 3-0, which means this is a clean win for Red Notice for winning 3-0.
I do have to say, sometimes it looks a little bit like Pasha is blocking his teammates so, because he wants to capture the flag.
Yeah, you know, that kind of trolling which happens, but you only do that when you are winning.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, I haven't seen anyone do that when a team is losing, in all honesty.
Yeah. Okay, and round number 3 is over.
And that will be the match going 3-0 to Red Notice. Honestly, really well played by both these teams, and despite it only being 3 rounds, I found it really enjoyable to watch.
Indeed.
I really do hope that you guys share that with us. Also, in case you guys didn't know, there's going to be yet another stream within 12 minutes. In that match, we'll be streaming Horizon versus... let me take a quick look. Horizon versus Toxic. So make sure to come check that one out as well. We'll have a new promo code ready for you guys. So we'll be waiting for you there.
Mm-hmm.
All right, for now I just want to thank The Legend for commentating. I want to thank John for broadcasting this game. And thank you guys so much for watching. I thank you, Kai, for being here
from the beginning of this stream. Sorry that I wasn't here. I hope that you guys have enjoyed. We'll be having another match with another promo code, with another intense gameplay. So yeah, stick out with us, and we will see you in 10 minutes.
See you guys then. Goodbye.